did you think there was going to be an autotrace release and I wouldn't make a video about it? I'm obviously back with another autotrace tutorial on our latest autotrace mode, illustration. Did I mention this is about autotrace? To start off, I'm going to import this illustration by the amazing artist Kelly. So go to this plus button up here, import, and then photos. And there it is. Once you have your image ready, first select it. Then go to the style tab at the very top. And you'll notice that now we have a brand new autotrace mode called illustration. I adjusted the minimum puff size to 13. Level of detail to high. Left everything else as it is. And then I tap on autotrace. Now everything is vector, so let's mess around with it. After ungrouping it, of course. What I want to do today is first to click here. This selects all my shapes. And then I go all the way to the last tab, which has our effects. And I want to use this option, blend back to front. The first try is not so good looking, but if we undo and perform again, this is another result we might get. And now it's great, but it can be amazing. So what I want to do is play with these colors and adjust them because they blend too much into each other. I want to select more objects at once, so tap on multi-select mode here. And now I've selected this, for example. So I'm going to use the eyedropper tool to give them this shade of red. Basically, every color is going to be based on the same red, but adjusted, so it's darker, lighter, more or less saturated. Simply put, monochromatic. A lot more can be done, so I'm going to multi-select some of these shapes here and change their color. I could go from the inspector, but I can also use color widget, which has the same exact options. You will see me going back and forth. So I've picked this shade of light coral. But now I see that this should probably be lighter because they are clouds. Oh, this was actually part of her hair. So just play around as you please and see what options you have, how they work and contrast with each other. For the lips, I think I want something a bit more intense, like the lips usually are, compared to the rest of the face. And I see that the face is a bit too bright compared to the sky, so I want to adjust it a little bit too. Or maybe the shapes around the face are too bright in comparison to the face? This or that, anyway, I think let's make clouds lighter. Also, this one in the original was a bit different, so let's tweak it a little bit to create more contrast in the whole artwork. Here I see that some elements were vectorized together, so we need to fix that. What I mean is that here is where the shoulder should have been. Let's take the pencil tool and adjust the smoothing to around 50%. And now I will just draw here a shape. Let's select it. Okay, it's still a bit uneven, so what I want to do is go to the Path tab and delete nodes. You can see how the nodes are basically deleted by some non-disclosed amount, so just tap until you can't tap anymore. Okay, I take that back. Maybe you should go one or two steps back, so I can still have a couple of nodes that I can adjust manually. Let's also close the path here, because I see that it's still open. Once done, I want to color this shape the same as the background. So then our very hard work makes sense. But now we also need to move it to the back, because there are some clouds here. So in quick actions, in stack order, just hold your pencil until it goes through all the other elements. Okay, as usual, I overdid it a bit. Now it looks good. Okay, so now you can see the shoulder and the t-shirt. I could still play around with the different colors and shades. Feel free to experiment with your own color palette. It does not have to be so monochromatic like mine. But for now, is it Berenika approved? Of course it is. So this is where we end the tutorial. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my amazing videos. I think I smell more autotrace tutorials. Stay tuned. Bye.